It's Nicola Rovermosselberg, advertiser. I am with Father Sipo, one of the leaders of the Godly Governance Network. He's addressing a community meeting today at the college. And my question to him is, Father, what exactly is it that you are trying to achieve through this dialogue?
Yes. Yeah, this is a dialogue that is intended to bring about cohesion, unity, and transformation within the community. It is not basically about the dias issue, but it has to do with the broader transformation issues, which includes issues of moral renewal, include issues of transformation, spiritual revival.
Okay, but you mentioned dias, and the whole idea is that there's members of the community objecting to the name of the dias festival. Would you care to expand on that?
One of the central issues that have been raised by the community is the annual celebration of the Dias Festival, because communities have got different perspectives in terms of what are the objectives of Dias being lifted up as if it is an event or where there was a harmonious meeting of cultures. There's a belief that that narrative is false and it is devoid of truth. And therefore, there's a need for the whole community of Mossel Bay to begin to interact and debate, to find common understanding on issues that they can celebrate together instead of issues that they can throw them apart.
Father Sipo, have you actually had dialogue also with the organizers of the festival?
We have tried to speak with the council of the mayor, because we invited the mayor to come into this thing to do an opening remarks and present what is the council's perspective and why council continues celebrating Dias in Mossel Bay. But we have not had any response from that. But I've spoken also to many other community leaders and church leaders and even community-based organizations. There's generally a discontent around this issue of celebrating Dias, especially the Khoi community leaders. You know, I spoke to the one councillor who was a Khoi leader, who said he has raised this matter in council many times. And many other councillors have raised this matter many times, but the issues that they are ignored, you know. The argument that has always been put forward by the council is that it is an economic opportunity, you know. And I'm saying, no, it is also not true, because even the people who benefit and participate economically into the processes of Dias, it's only the few elected and well-established business people. The majority of people are not part of that. But more than that, the issue is that there are certain foundations that were laid through the landing of Bartholomew Dias that have not been dealt by the community. Which foundations, I think, through this debate and interaction, will have to be brought up, because the basis for any unity and transformation must be based on truth, and it must be founded on things that are real.
Father, you mention dialogue and all that, but apart from the lectures that you are now having today, what do you see as the way forward?
This is the beginning of an engagement, community engagement. It's going to spread to all the wards. It's going to spread to all the stakeholders within the community. We're going to engage with the municipality in a formal way, and we make sure that by the time the next 3rd of February comes, at least there is consensus in terms of how this festival should be celebrated. We're not saying that there shouldn't be a Harbors Festival celebration, but we're saying, what are the objectives of centering those celebrations around Bartholomew Dias? Because Bartholomew Dias to me means misery, but to other people it means everything else, you know. And I'm saying that we must find a consensus, a common narrative that will unite the Mossel Bay community, that will be followed and understood by everybody.
Thank you very much for speaking to the advertiser.
Yes, basically we want to call for a public participation approach into all these issues that we think are controversial, and the municipality is the only vehicle that is closer to the people and that must be accepted by the people to drive public participation consultations on anything that is controversial, on anything that it wants to introduce, so that it's not us and them. So we want to close that gap between us and them, even when it comes to authorities and when it comes to communities, even when it comes to black and white, when it comes to religious sectors or church leaders. We need to find a common ground to transform Mossel Bay for the better of our communities.
Thank you, Father Sipo.
Yes.